Hello and good evening. My name is John. We're here playing Poncho as part of my Steam Movies series. I go through every game in my Steam library, eventually then arbitrarily rate and review them after the playtime. I don't quite know what this game is, but looks like it's in a dilapidated city. We're going to push play and find out together. A little music in my left channel ear here. Nothing. Oh, here comes the right channel. So far, time to Poncho is over 30 seconds. I want to push the A button. Nothing. Wait. Alright. We have some mode 7 going on here, some sprite scaling? No. This is just a particle effect barrier, projector. Oh geez. Here comes the city. The tower is really far away. What happens if I push start? Oh. Okay, this is a turn. I'm wearing a poncho. 1 minute 25 seconds. Alright, so I have a variable jump. Good parallax. Oh. We have ponchoed. Alright, I got a red bit. Every platform is friendly to rise up and meet me. Hey, what? Oh, jeez. Okay, we got the plane shifting stuff. Confusing with the switching there, but I'll get a hang of it. That's more on me than the game. Why is there a timer? So, you have finally woken. Welcome back, my child. My Poncho. If you are reading this, then it means that I capitalized my S's, that I have failed and the world has ended. When I made you, I hid something inside. Your Poncho. With it, you can release me and humanity can begin again. Daddy? Go for it! Save me, help me, what have I done? No! Poncho, no! They're going really hard for that meta intro. I mean, so far the games are pretty cool, just really heavy-handed in the start here. Oh no, everything is broken, except for me and my poncho. So are these red bits currency? Y'all? Play title card? Okay, so it didn't reset me, it actually fell down. Sometimes my head gets foggy. I don't know who you are. There's no one looking after me anymore, that's kind of sad. Why not? Oh, do I need to go here?
Hello, Ernie.
Hello? Do you shop? Okay. Alright, so you just sell me keys.
Thank you.
Oh, you're welcome. Is this a no shift shield? Enough. I don't know if this is where I'm supposed to go. I did a thing. Is that a blueprint? Jump wall midair to smash. Oops, why do I want this? Okay, we're in a discotheque. Weird. Oh no! What?
Yeah.
can't stomp on him. Hello? Okay. Oh, jeez. Why do I keep dying? There's clearly something here I'm not quite understanding. Is it? Okay, if I just stay on it, is it gonna drop me off? Yeah, okay. Yeah, I thought I was going forward. Okay, but I did touch ground there. Alright, I think I can do this. This is more complex than I would think it would be. We did it! Let me out. Let me out. Let me out. How do I leave, robots? How do I leave, robots? Robots, how do I leave? Oh, I just wait. Okay. That was not made clear. Did I do this already? Was the warp gate? I got the achievement called The Journey Begins. Okay, there we go. Wait, what? I got all the keys out of there, not all the bits. Game's kind of cool, but it's really bad at onboarding. Blink. Orange, does that mean they're going away? That's what I'm not getting right. I have to do transitions while jumping. Okay. One key. Junkyard. Alright, let's take a little peek here. This falls in one of those categories that the game is perfectly fine. It's got a cute little protagonist, but mechanically, I'm just not, like, getting hooked. I feel like this would be better if there was more colored illumination. I mean, they do shading. But if there was more colored illumination between the layers, I might have a better time remembering which layer is which. Those are cool sequences, don't get me wrong. Oh no, a big reveal! Dun dun! Live from Madison Square Garden, Daft Punk! Freedom! Good day, Manin. As I, the Junkyard King. Is it just you then? Where is my magnificent army? Where are my subjects? This is most puzzling. Must have been taken from me. Bah. Okay, this isn't a problem. We'll just get them back. Minion, I'm going to give you a gift. Using this gift, you'll be able to send my subjects back to me. Okay. Just go in the world and find them. They must be scattered everywhere. Okay. Enough chatter, go do this for me and you shall be greatly rewarded. Ability unlock! Blueprint? Oh, okay. I'm alive, I shall return to my king. Big white screen. Oh, Oh, that's some weird popping right there. Not sure what's causing that. Is that the end of the junkyard? Yeah, I guess so. Oh, now it shows me how many robots I need to fix. That's cool. The world, all right, the world shifts with you. Okay, so these blocks move with me. All right, so that's a new mechanic. Wait, what? Are they out of sync now? They are out of sync. Oh. Alright, that's weird. Falling to my death has changed the order of the blocks. Huh. This has been PONCHO, a 2D platformer with the ability to jump between axes. We've seen the mechanic before. This game does an okay job with it, but I feel that their visual language, with the amount of parallax they have, does not give you enough key elements to, you know, distinguish. The area I got stuck in a lot where they were timing stuff, there was no audio cue for it, and I feel that for me, audio cues really help when things are transitioning. They had that heavy rock music, and maybe there was a cue to the rock music, I just didn't catch on to it. Overall, it's a really cute experience, but the level design doesn't match up to the level of cuteness here, and I find that the goals are a little arbitrary, and maybe a map would help in some situations, but they might have stuff that unlocks that I haven't seen yet. But in the meantime, this has been PONCHO. Cheers.